Hello, everybody. This is me, Alberto Kennedy, aka Grimoire. I posted a video about empathic abilities, and I wanted to I elaborated basically on the different abilities an empath can have. Well, the volume somehow got messed up. So I was gonna leave it there, and I apologize for it, but I can't go out like that. So I posted this new video, and I think I fixed the volume glitch. Because nothing but the best for my peeps, you know, if they're watching and everything. And I don't like to do things half-assed. So this is the new version of volume fixed. All right, hope you like. Thank you. Much love and light. And this video segment, it's going to be discussing, and I'm looking at my notes, empathic abilities. I went into empathic abilities in one of my other videos, but this one is a little bit more in depth. I have a friend, a longtime friend of mine. His name is Braden Russell. This video is for you, Braden. He wanted to know, what is the extent of empathic abilities? Are there any, you know how abilities can be passive or aggressive? Passive meaning they're more spiritual, they're more mental, or in this case, emotional, since empathic abilities is rooted in the emotions. Can empathic abilities affect the physical environment around you? Yes, they can. These are some of the ways empathic abilities can evolve. I'm going to share this with you. Anybody who is an empath, their abilities can naturally evolve into the manifestations that I am going to share with you right now. Okay, so for the first level of empathic abilities is a sensitive. Now, a psychic sensitive, you've heard of that, where they can sense the energies and entities and people, places, and things. Okay. And this is for, they can sense the dead, because emotions on the dead can give off emotional energy as well. So an empath is, in fact, a medium. And if they work their abilities, open meditation, honing their abilities, they would be what you would call a sensitive or an empathic sensitive or an empathic medium. Okay, and that's pretty much for all empaths to varying degrees. Keep in mind, it's varying degrees because some people have their empathic ability full blown; it's already fully developed. They're naturals. Others, it takes them a while to get familiarized with their abilities. You know, because it's you don't just all of a sudden one day you're instant psychic. Hey, I have abilities. It doesn't work that way. It requires work. It requires effort. It requires training, and it requires you learning the ins and outs and the intricacies of your abilities. And the best way to do that is to get familiarized with who you are on the inside. Okay, so the first level is a sensitive. An empath is in fact, sensitive. They're sensitive to the energies around them, and they can sense and feel the energies inherent in people, places, and things. This includes the dead. The second level for an empath, my notes, empathic influencer. This is where it gets a little deeper. They can project emotions towards others, influencing others with emotional energy to make them feel a certain way. They can alter the emotions of people, places, and things. This is similar to what a psychokinetic can do in terms of pushing, where a person who is more mental or has more of developed their psychic ability, they can psychokinetically influence another person's thoughts, their personality, and they can make them do things just by thinking about it. Well, an empathic influencer is the same thing. The only difference is they're doing it via their emotions. They can superimpose their emotions, their agendas, their feelings onto another person, place, or thing, or persons, places, and things. It doesn't have to be singular. It can be plural. They can do it, you know, to more than just one, you know, target. And they can influence them. And this is an empathic influencer, and that's pretty deep. And that's when you have a strong control over your empathic ability, where you can superimpose your agenda onto something else and make them do what you want them to do emotionally. For example, you go into a location that is kind of hostile towards you, or you just sense hostility in the air and the anger and all those types of emotions, right? Well, what you can do if you're a learned empath is that you can push your influence into that environment, thinking positive energies or feeling happiness, joy, and those good emotions. You know, you just click on a memory that makes you really happy and you project that outward. You will be influencing that environment. Empaths can do this. And that environment will be much more agreeable, and you would be counteracting the inherent negativity in that environment. You can do this to people, places, and things. When I say things, you can do that to pets, you can do that to plants, you can do that to, you know, people, places, and things. This is done instinctively, by the way. So we as empaths can do this and have done this, but we may not be conscious about it. Your abilities increase tenfold when you are in fact conscious about what you're doing with your emotions and emotional and the energy inherent in emotions. All right. And we're not done. We have a third one. Absorption. Empathic absorption. This is a tricky ability, because the fact is all empaths are absorbing emotions 24/7. That's how come sometimes they can easily get overwhelmed, you know? This absorption ability is already active. If you're an empath, you have absorption abilities, and they are active. For caregivers, for example, if you are helping your clients and they're going through a great deal of pain, discomfort, and just are frustrated, and sometimes they can be a bit ornery, because hello, who isn't ornery when they're in pain? Hello. Well, if you're an empathic caregiver, you absorb that. You absorb that, and then you start getting those symptoms. You start feeling those symptoms. It doesn't mean you have the same thing your clients have. No, don't get scared. What that just means is that you're absorbing that energy, because instinctively, if you're a caregiver, you are compassionate to what they're going through, and you are taking that in yourself. You're absorbing that energy. Well, we can go a step further with that. You can go into, you know, a different environment, and you're absorbing the energy of that environment. Sometimes the environments we find ourselves in can be negative. And if we're absorbing that negativity, that can affect us adversely. So this absorption happens a great deal, you know, with empaths. This is the cross that most empaths have to bear. So what I would urge you to do if you're to get your absorption abilities under control is to find a filtration mechanism to purify the energies within you and around you, and to become a purifier yourself, where you are transmuting. Transmutation is key, people. You have to be able to transmute the energy that you're absorbing constantly. And once you start learning to transmute these energies, it'll become second nature. And that's a piece of your abilities, a piece of a puzzle, if you will, that will help you with your absorption capabilities. This instinctive ability can wreak havoc if it's unchecked, as is the case with most empathic people. They get overwhelmed. They tend to get sick a lot. They tend to get depressed a lot. They, you know, extremes of moods and everything. You're not going crazy. It's just the energies that you're absorbing. You're absorbing without a filtration mechanism. You're not filtering. You're not transmuting. And so you're at the mercy of the energies you're absorbing, and that can't be. You know, you have to be in control of yourself at all times. Because you matter. Just as much as empathic people are very compassionate and they want to, you know, help this world and whatnot, well, you can't help the world if you yourself are broken. So you have to love yourself enough to say, hey, I love to help people, but I need to be okay with me too, you know. And so we want to transmute. And I have another video in my channel. Look at that video. It talks about transmutation. It's a bit heady in the sense that it gets into principles that are occult in nature, but you can implement those occult, those transmutation principles, to assist you with your absorption capabilities, because you're absorbing empathic energy or emotional energy all around you at all times. And you want to, you know, protect yourself internally. But that's the ability, empathic absorption. All right. Now, the following abilities are a bit stronger, a bit more developed, and affect the physical world around you, through your own emotions. The following empathic abilities fall under the category of empathic and psychic vampirism. Buckle your seatbelts, boo, it's going to get cray-cray. Okay, empathic vampirism. What does that mean? That sounds almost kind of spooky and everything. No, let me dispel that, the myth behind that. It's not scary. An empath can consciously feed or drain emotional energy from people, places, and things. Now, it's similar to absorption, but absorption is instinctive. If an empath is learned enough where they can consciously drain, which means that they are doing it on purpose, they can drain emotional energy from a person, place, or thing. Because it's food. I mean, keep in mind, energy is energy. Especially if you have strong transmutational skills. It's like food. It's like mother's milk. It's regenerative. And sometimes it comes in handy. I'll explain. But empathic vampires can feed off of pain, suffering, sadness. They have to transmute these things, by the way, because these are very toxic emotions that can cause damage physically in the long term. But they can also feed off of joy, love, pleasure. Empathic vampirism naturally leads, because remember, if you're empathic, you're a dormant psychic. And sometimes your psychic ability isn't really that dormant. But empathic vampirism naturally leads to psychic vampirism. Psychic vampires can feed off the psychic energy around somebody. They can feed off of their life force. They can feed off of their health. They can feed off of their wealth around them. How do you feed off of wealth? Keep in mind, wealth is just energy. Wealth is just energy. Money, success, and all that, that's energy. That's a idea, that's a paradigm that we physicalize with our actions, with our hard work, with our goal-oriented actions and all that. So it's energy, and you can feed off of that too. Okay? Everything is energy. So an empathic vampire has latent or active psychic vampire abilities as well. Okay? And so you can affect a psychic vampire and an empathic vampire can affect people, places, and things. Note. This is my notes. Sometimes I get ahead of myself. Absorbing emotional energy can be dangerous if you don't have an understanding, again, of transmutation. Think of transmutation like recycling or purifying. I mean, you know how Brita, those Brita things, we purify water. You can purify things. Well, energy is the same. You have to purify it. You can use crystals for purification if you are still working on instituting transmutation technique that works for you, fine, take your time. But until then, because you're going to still keep absorbing, because that's instinctive that all empaths do, you can use shungite stone. I talk about that in my last video. It's a purification stone. Works wonders. Obsidian works wonders. But be very careful with obsidian, because it will bring out your fears, your negative side, all the stuff that you carry, so you can see it, because it's a transmutation stone. It's very powerful. So these crystals will help you a great deal in terms of creating a filter energy system within yourself, so you can filter the energy you're absorbing. And even psychic vampires have already a built-in powerful transmutation system. That's how they're so conscious that they know what they're doing, you know, when they're feeding off of empathic and emotional energy. Also, basic ways to transmute, easy ways to transmute. Hug a tree. I know that sounds weird, right? Back in the 60s, they used to hug trees, and you call them tree huggers. And they were smart, because Native Americans back in the day used to know that the tree is connected to the sky and the earth. The tree, standing people, as they used to call them, they are natural transmutation masters. They can transmute. Their energy is all about transmutation. Hug a tree. Walk barefoot on the earth. The earth, one of its many powers, this planet of ours, it transmutes. It can transmute. And that's what it does. Carry shungite stone, obsidian stone, malachite crystal is a very powerful stone. It has a high copper content, very, very conducive to spiritual energy and cleansing. And also meditation helps you with your transmutation. All right. Second to the last, this type of empath is very, very rare. The sin eater empath. Okay, now, what's a sin eater? That sounds, ooh, so creepy and everything. It's really not. A sin eater is rare, and their ability is also rare, because they take it a step further in terms of energy absorption. It's the ability to absorb or feed off of guilt energy, karmic energy, and the most toxic energies and the effects of those energies, that were the result of a negative action, okay? So, for example, if somebody has led a life of darkness, of violence, and of just hateful acts, but then, you know how we all evolve, sometimes people who have led that kind of life realize what they're doing, and then there's just this overwhelming sense of guilt and a need to atone. Before they atone, or during the atonement process, which is more like a penance process for their soul that they're undergoing, that they choose to undergo for their life that they led, they tend to hurt themselves. They tend to punish themselves, which doesn't help the situation. If you're going to make up for the spiritual or physical crimes that you did, you destroying yourself accomplishes nothing. You're not changing what you did, and you can never change what you have done. The guilt is going to always be there. But you can balance that out by leading a positive life, making a difference for people, helping people, not hurting people. But some of these people who carry that guilt end up destroying themselves slowly. Well, a sin eater, if those people are rare enough to find a sin eater, they're in luck. Because if a sin eater so chooses, a sin eater will absorb that guilt, absorb that pain, absorb that karma that they have incurred, and they can take it upon themselves, freeing that person to continue to help people better, and make this world a better place, to atone, you know? A sin eater is very rare. There has been many sin eaters in the Santeria gods, that they're orishas. There's a lot of sin eaters. The Aztec gods were sin eaters. There are many entities that were sin eaters. Well, empaths carry that. There are some empaths that can be sin eaters. And they're very powerful empaths. This ability is old. Anunnaki old. Sumerian owned, but it does exist. Some people who are Sin Eaters don't even know that they are Sin Eaters, because their Sin Eaters come with a built-in, overemphasized sense of humility. Okay, but this, it's great because they can even recycle karmic energy. Freaking awesome, you know, right? All right, last ability. Oh, and a Sin Eater can affect the physical, material, spiritual, emotional levels, on all levels. They can affect. And they can bring good tidings. They can bring good energies with the emotional energy that they have, you know, with their empathic ability. They can bring good things, you know, good happenings, good events and whatnot. And also they can bring dark things. Everybody wants redemption, even the people that don't deserve it. But then again, you know, balance, right? All right, moving on. The fifth manifestation of an empath's ability, and the most powerful, next to the Sin Eater, most powerful, is psychokinetic abilities. Now, get this. An empath has latent or dormant psychokinetic abilities. Wait a minute. The anatomy of psychokinesis, or psychokinetic energy, if you will, is emotions and the psychological associations attached to those emotions, which triggers psychic abilities and the effects on the physical and material level. Things physically move when you can focus your emotions and the psychological associations attached to those emotions. That's how poltergeists are created. Now, if an empath is cunning enough to control his emotions or her emotions and the psychological associations attached to those emotions, you can affect the physical world around you. You can affect the spiritual and all levels. It's multidimensional, mind you. And you can also, if you really learn, create psychokinetic entities like poltergeists. The only difference is you're consciously doing it, and these entities are extensions of your will, and you can make shit happen. This is what I have, very powerful, and to develop these abilities, you have to be aware of them, number one. Number two, you have to meditate. Number three, you cannot affect the world around you without proper control of your inner world. You need to have a good connection with who you are before you try to affect the world. You need to know what your motives and intentions are. Some of these empathic abilities will be stronger than others, and it's very rare for all of these abilities to be fully developed and active in an empath. You're not going to all of a sudden be, you know, Jean Grey, you know, Phoenix, Dark Phoenix and whatnot. It's not comics, Lou, no. However, you have all of these abilities that I just described in you if you're an empath. Your job is to develop your abilities, develop them, and they will be strong. Some will be stronger than others. You're also in the pursuit of your empathic abilities and the training and the exercises that you choose to do, meditation and all that. You're going to trigger and active your psychic abilities, which will make your psychokinetic talent all the more stronger. Because an empath, emotions is just one component of psychokinetic energy. There's also the psychic and psychological associations attached to the emotions that you feel. That they are the ingredients to psychokinetic energy. Also, there's always one person that will take this knowledge and try to abuse it to become some kind of evil Professor X, Cassandra Nova status, or whatever. Well, let me tell you like this. Abusing your abilities leaves you vulnerable to karmic law. And even predators have predators. And there are some empathic people out there that feed on dark empaths. I don't know anything. That's what my research told me. Sharing with you. Alright. So if you have any questions, please let me know. I hope this information finds you well. I'm just trying to bring light to dark places. Let's all help each other. Let's all develop our abilities. Let's try to change this world, but this world really does need some help. Okay, thank you guys, and more videos coming soon. And thank you, Wade and Russell, for asking about